Welcome back, Rachel.
Hello.
So we'd like to know that after you found out you were BRCA positive, how did you come to the decision about prophylactic surgery?
Well, the first thing I did was take some time to absorb the information. And then I was very proactive in researching. I spoke to many doctors and surgeons. I spoke to people who had decided to go ahead and have the prophylactic surgery. I spoke to women who decided not to and were being monitored as a high-risk patient. I learned about the potential side effects and risks involved and thought long and hard about why I decided to have this testing and what the reasons were for wanting to really decrease the anxiety that goes along with knowing that you are at a very high risk for developing cancer.
Is there any particular advice that you'd give anyone who maybe just found out they, you know, have a genetic mutation?
Yeah, I think the more people that you can speak with, the best. The surgeons will give you information, generally they'll just give you information on what the surgery entails, but there are other factors to consider, and the more people you can speak with, the more information, the more places like T.E.A.L. and there are other organizations that can help you speak with other women who are going through the same decision-making process or who have made their decisions. It really makes you feel less alone, and it gives you so much more information than you can get from just, you know, reading an online article or speaking with a doctor.
And we get a lot of questions too if people are trying to decide if they should even get genetic testing done in the first place. So some people are very active about it or a little standoffish about it. So maybe as you were thinking about getting genetic testing done, was there something that you'd like to share with people as advice of why they should do this or to help them make that decision?
Yeah, I mean, I think ultimately when you're dealing with cancer, knowledge is power. And once you're diagnosed with cancer, your options are somewhat limited, and this gives you this position that you can be proactive. Ultimately, it is a huge decision, and there are a lot of factors to consider, but if you're in a position where you're able to have some knowledge and be able to do something about it, I don't see that there's any downsides to at least having that knowledge, at least having those options.
And it just in regards to, you know, speaking to your family about this, when you have that knowledge before or after, sometimes we then find out that other family members could be at risk or there is a gene in the family. How did you talk to your family about this whole idea of genetic testing or your results?
Well, my family had experienced a lot of cancer, and so there was a lot of anxiety anyway about everybody's health. So I think there was some relief in knowing that there is something you can do. I mean, if it turns out you don't have the mutation, but there is cancer in your family, you can still be monitored as high risk, but this is something you can do that really decreases your risk to almost nothing. And so I think there was a general sense of relief that this was not going to be my story. And once I found out about the mutation, other members of my family did get tested, and obviously there are some who have the mutation as well, and now they can be monitored and decide if there's something that they want to do for themselves.
And how would you say that T.E.A.L. has helped you so far?
It's always good to be surrounded with other women who are grappling with these decisions, and since I had the surgery about 6 or 7 years ago, I'm in a position where I can help and try to advise or at least give my experience to other women. The one thing I'll say is that it's really a personal decision, and you have to take into consideration what your tolerance for risk is and where you are in your life. And so it's helpful to me. It's cathartic to me to be able to help other women.
Great. Well, come and join us to some of our free T.E.A.L. workshops. Rachel's a part of one of them for prophylactic and genetics. We also give genetic counseling workshops as well. And hopefully We'll see Rachel again, maybe on our teal couch. So thank you, Rachel.
You're welcome.
Thanks, everybody, for joining us, and email us any questions. Bye.
Bye.